Hi, this is Robin Heppel from FuneralFuturist.com, and welcome to the Funeral Strategy and Marketing Show. This is a little video that I'm going to do on a regular basis so that I can share with you and other funeral professionals just some of my experiences, tips, and strategies for you to have your funeral home more strategic, more competitive, and win more calls, serve more families. And that's what it's all about to me, is if I can help you serve more families, and if you provide better funeral services than your competition, then I believe my job is being done. So I think that's awesome. What we're going to talk about today is setting up Google AdWords. And Google AdWords is a very effective marketing tool. It allows you to get in front of people who are searching for funeral homes and cremation services. And the great thing is you only pay for when someone clicks on your ad. So unlike the Yellow Pages or any other type of marketing, you pay up front. This is what they call pay-per-click. So you only pay when someone clicks on your ad. Now, the first thing you're going to think of is, hey, I don't want my competitor clicking on my ad. And sure, none of us do. You know, the reality is that's going to happen a couple times. But if it happens a lot, a couple things happen. One is that Google can track click fraud. it's not much of a tongue twister, but so they can track click fraud. And if they, so they can then either reverse those charges and, you know, don't even worry about that. The other thing is the more your ad gets clicked, Google thinks it's a better ad. So if your ad's getting clicked three times as much as your competitor's ad, Google's actually going to give you credit and give you what they call a higher quality score. And by giving a higher quality score, you're going to actually have a higher placement and pay less than you would if you didn't have a higher quality score. So don't click on your competitor's ads that often, maybe once or twice, and don't click on your ads that often. And actually, don't search every day to see where your ads are ranking, because if you keep searching and you never click on your ads, you're going to actually lower your click-through rate for those ads. So, but what I want to talk about today is just setting up your Google AdWords campaign. And there's throughout the whole process now that we can get into writing the ads and creating the landing pages and things like that. But just the setup, you know, people can do a good job and they can also do a real crappy job. So let's get you off on the right foot here. And I just want to, first of all, mention, you know, we want to make sure that our campaign isn't too broad. Then we're going to look at making sure that we have specific ad groups. And also, we don't want to forget about setting up negative keywords. So let me step back and just explain how this is put together. So when you create your account, the first thing that you do is you create a campaign. And the first thing that I like to do is create a campaign, and I usually call it local. And so that would be your one main market. And in that market, you set it for a certain radius. And so maybe it's a 15-mile radius, a 10-mile radius, whatever it is in your market. And now if you have multiple locations, maybe you're going to cover all of them, or if they're in different towns, you may want to have then two campaigns where you cover one radius around this town and then another radius around another town. But we'll get into that a little bit later. Then what happens is inside your campaigns, you set up ad groups. And this is another problem that I see happen is, you know, funeral homes will just have ad group one because that's the ad group number one, because that's the default title that Google puts on there. So if I see campaign number one and then ad group number one, I know that people haven't really put a lot of thought into building up their campaigns. Now, one of the problems is people then dump all the keywords all in that one ad group, and then they drive them all to one page, their homepage, which is a bad choice. What I like to do is after I've created the local campaign, inside of that, I make four ad groups. So the four ad groups are funeral homes, funeral costs, cremation services, and cremation costs. And why I break those apart is that then I can put all of the searches for when people are searching for a funeral home or mortuary or funeral directors in a specific location, then they then show ads that just talk about that. So if a death has occurred, you know, you can call us or, you know, visit our website or download our resource kit. And it's a bit more generic. But if someone's looking for funeral costs, then you can have a more specific ad and actually drive them to a more specific landing page where you're going to be having a different conversation, more about costs. And then same with cremation. Instead of having all your cremation keywords lumped in with your funeral keywords, you know, they're different as well. So I like to break those apart. And then so the cremation services ad group is very similar to the funeral homes ad group. And then we have the cremation costs ad group, which is just similar to the funeral costs one, but is, you know, how much is a cremation? What is the price of a cremation? How much does a cremation cost? All those keyword phrases, and then they drive to a page that talks about cremation costs. So that's how I like to set up the ad groups. And then one thing that before we kind of wrap that up, that initial setup, is it's important to add in negative keywords. Now, lots of people, it's good to put in keywords, but sometimes, you know, they can get too vague. And I like to put in negative keywords. So if you don't have a pet service, like a pet crematorium service, then you don't want to rank for pet cremation in your market. And but if you didn't put pet in as a negative keyword, then your ad may show up and someone may click on it and you're just wasting money because you can't serve that person. And if you don't, if they don't click on it, you're just making that ad look like it's not as good because your click-through rate's going to go down. Because so the number of people clicking on that ad, you know, if 0 out of 100 click on that ad, then you have a 0% click-through rate. And just, you know, just in your mind to keep what we look for and what we try to go for is we try to average anywhere from, for the more general terms like funeral homes, 3 to 4% click-through rate, even up to 5%. And on the cost ones, even though there isn't as many services, we like to see that up into the 10% range. And some of them are even more than that. All depends on the market. The cost per click all depends on the market. You could be in some markets where it's less than $1 for the term funeral homes. You can then be in some more competitive markets for cremation that could be $5, $6, $7 a click. So you want to make sure that you really dial this stuff in. Now, one thing is if you have multiple locations, you would want to then, I wouldn't just create a second ad group. I'd actually create a second campaign. And what you can do, there's this great tool called the AdWords Editor, and it's a piece of software that you download to your PC or your Mac, and but it's produced by Google. And then what you can do is you download all the data from your AdWords account into your AdWords Editor. And from there, I would just duplicate the local number one, the local campaign number one, and then name it for the new market. And then you can go in into the AdWords Editor, and you can actually do find and replace. Now you're going to clunk around for a little bit, but don't worry. You can if you make a mistake, it doesn't happen automatically. You're not uploading those back to your account. You can actually then just start all over again and work with it. So what I would do in this case is after I've copied it, do a find and replace. So if I was say here in British Columbia. And so I had a campaign for, this would never work because we're separated by a body of water, but if we had a campaign for Victoria funeral homes and Victoria cremation costs, I could then just duplicate that and then just do and for the Vancouver market, and then it would be Vancouver funeral homes and Vancouver cremation costs, etc. The reason why we put that into two different campaigns is because at the campaign level is where you set your geographical boundaries. So that's why I would do it from a campaign perspective if you're doing two different markets. And then as you set up your market for the kind of the different topics, we would then go into the different ad groups. And then from there, we're going to put in our keywords and we're going to write at least 2 ads per ad group so that we're always split testing to see which ad works better. And probably for another episode, we'll talk about landing pages and actually the content of how to what to put on that landing page and then work backwards of how to create a really good ad. But we'll talk about that in an upcoming episode. So hopefully that just gives you a quick overview of how to set up your account. And if you want more information on that, I've got a special website called funeraladwords.com. And there's some videos on there. And also, too, you could just go to my YouTube channel. And there's a whole bunch of marketing Q&A questions in there. And a lot of them pertain to Google AdWords. So I hope you like this new way of me communicating. I'm still going to do the our screen capture videos that we put up on YouTube, and they're more of an on-screen tutorial. But for these ones, I thought, you know, this is a little bit better. You can, you know, I'm not hiding behind the screen. I'm here speaking with you, and you know, let me know what you think. You can leave a comment below, and also make sure that you subscribe to this on iTunes. And speaking of that, we've just launched my scientific advertising audiobook on iTunes. So you can actually download the entire book for free. This is where I have read aloud the book Scientific Advertising by Claude Hopkins. Plus, I've given about a 1-hour interpretation of how are the dots connected for funeral service. So, and then you can just, if you want, carry me on the go. Now, the good thing is about this is that you can set it, especially if you have an iPhone, you can go 2 times the speed. So if you want to not, if you don't want to listen to me, or if you want to condense it, just go up to from 1 times to 1.5 or 2 times. So I've got this on, you know, I've created this DVD set that people can purchase, or sometimes I give it away when I'm speaking at a conference. But now you can also just get it for free. And you can just go to iTunes and search for funeral advertising or for Robin Heppel under podcasts, and it'll come up. And this is actually the book. So Scientific Advertising was written in 1923 by Claude Hopkins. And it is an amazing book. And there's such gems in here that they're still true today. So I think you'll enjoy it, and there's lots of great nuggets of how I've interpreted it and how it can help your funeral home. So just go to iTunes and search for funeral advertising or Robin Heppel, and you'll see it, and download it for free, listen to it, and if you don't want to listen to the entire 2.5, 3 hours, just hit it on 2 times, and it'll be just over an hour. But it is pretty heavy stuff, so you may want to absorb it a couple times. Also, just want to let you know that it's going to be a real busy fall, so it means that my summer's going to be busy. It'll be relaxing here in the Pacific Northwest, enjoying our nice, mild summer weather. But just want to let you know what's coming up. We've got the Funeral Boot Camp, which is going to be September 9th, 10th, and 11th in Cleveland, Ohio. And that's where we're going to be talking about just building your web presence and everything that you need to do to maximize that online, whether it's from SEO, whether it is how to integrate your social media, how to use social media to its maximum effectiveness without going overboard, and also for reputation management, how to get a lot more positive reviews and how to put that into your system at the funeral home. So that's where we're going to be talking about there. Then in October, I'm going to be in Austin at NFDA, and there I'm actually going to be talking about winning calls with Google, and a lot of it's going to be about Google AdWords, and we're going to go into that a lot more detail. It's a 2-hour workshop, so you know, be prepared. It's early in the morning, but it's going to be worth it. And then in November, I'm having my my second Funeral Rockstars event, and this one is actually going to be about competitive strategies. So I'm really looking forward to that. It's going to be at the Planet Hollywood right on the Strip. And the people that were at the last one Had a great time, and I'm looking forward to seeing them and hopefully you there at one of those three events. And once again, thanks for allowing me to have a little bit of your day, and we'll talk to you real soon. This is Robin Heppel from funeralfutures.com.